thousands of overpopulation for you to deal with. We're not cannons fodder for your wars!
We will fight for our freedom, because we know what freedom feels like. And this is not it! This is not it!
People think they're free, but they're not. We've been given the illusion of freedom, the illusion of choice.
It wasn't so much conspiracy theories themselves as it was the people who believe in them that attracted me.
You know, it really is a fascinating societal phenomenon, and it's one that we have to try to understand in order to dispel it.
We made a mistake. We made a huge mistake.
That's the genius of these rulers, that they've created this society that's conditioned to deny what's right in front of its eyes.
Which is what?
That we're slaves.
It's us, Terrence.
Oh.
How you doing?
Oh, buddy.
How's it going?
How are you?
Good.
Come on in. Come on. I didn't clean up or anything.
That's all right, man.
It's okay if we just grab lots of...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, take it a lot. Yeah.
Okay.
That's where I'm out of the world. I feel pretty exposed.
It's all right. No, look, like, we're just going to...
Excuse
take it.
The mess.
Hey, Firefly. This is T-Rex. How you doing?
This is what I call the war room, where I put up anything I read, any information I find, any event that occurs, any legislation that gets passed, I put up here. Okay, anything that I find to be significant. Let's look at some recent significant events from our friends, the government of the United States of America. 06, the Military Commissions Act passes, which allows U.S. citizens to be detained in undisclosed locations indefinitely. Boom!
And people always ask, how do I know that there's this huge conspiracy going on? If these all-powerful rulers are all-powerful, how come they let me stumble onto this information?
FEMA conducts training exercises for clergymen on how they can help the government quell dissent in the case of the enactment of martial law. Boom!
The answer's simple. I mean, it's easy to do the research that I did to find out the things that I did. It's easy to turn you into me, but you don't want to be me.
09, Bill H.R. 645 authorizes the Department of Homeland Security to set up a network of FEMA camps to intern U.S. citizens in the case of a national emergency. Right? You can justify them separately for all kinds of reasons, but when you connect them all up, the pattern emerges. You can see where it's leading.
Well, it was actually... this guy who first discovered Terrence.
I was sent a clip. You know, there's some random stupid thing.
Please do not slow down. Continue scurrying to your places of work. Continue concealing.
Hey. You are not people. You are sheeple. They're watching you. They're monitoring you.
Oh, you're listening to me. That must mean you are a psychopath.
Oh, and by the way, they're building camps when the hits the fan.
wasn't so much the video that fascinated me as much as it was the comments. It wasn't people making fun of him. It was people agreeing with him. Like, a lot of people. There's this entire group of people online, this underground, that believes the world is controlled by secret forces.
For generations, the people who secretly ran things have been able to hide because they owned all the traditional forms of media. The internet changed all that.
We get all kinds of people from all walks of life. The one thing that really ties our customers together is the fact that, you know, they all have this devotion to truth. Everybody has questions that aren't being answered.
The key is the Federal Reserve. The U.S. government is assured so-called financial stability because the Fed can just print more money out of thin air, but the government's always going to be in debt to the Fed. Always.
Why come to a store like this if the main source of your information is online?
Well, because the internet may be a threat to those in charge, but it's also their greatest weapon. Every single thing you do on the internet is monitored. Every email you send, every website you visit, every picture you look at on your wife's Facebook, all of this. And George Orwell predicted that Big Brother would be watching us one day, but what he didn't predict is that we'd create Big Brother ourselves and then willingly give ourselves over to it.
If you're searching keywords, if you're looking up hot material, if you're scouring internet conspiracy sites, definitely you're of an interest.
Something is coming. They are not stripping away our rights and our freedoms for the hell of it. You know, this country was created by militias. There's no American army when we overthrew the British. Now here we are 200 years later, and once again, tyrants have taken over the nation.
We hear a lot of people talk about they. Who are they?
In my opinion, the Bilderberg Group.
The Illuminati.
Bohemian Grove.
The Council on Foreign Relations.
Heidelberg.
The Carlyle Group.
Military Industrial Complex.
Rothschild. The Rockefeller.
WTO.
CIA. NSA.
MI6.
The IMF.
World Bank.
How do you handle all of this information? What does one person do with it all?
What I always tell my friends online is it's not enough to stay within our group to discuss these issues only within our own circles. We have to go out into the world. Other people's circles to let others know the truth by whatever means necessary.
Specifically that you hope to achieve?
They need to know that I know. Right? Alone, as one man, I'm no threat. But what I am is an idea. What I am is the embodiment of an idea. And if it occurred to me, it will eventually occur to other people as well. And then there'll be two people in the street with megaphones. Then there'll be 10 people in the street with megaphones. Then there'll be 100 people.
But what if they're not even listening?
Are you listening?
Well, me personally, am I?
Yes, that's what matters. If you're listening, if they're listening, Are you listening?
Looking back on it, I wish we had never listened to the thing he said.
We've tried, like, every possible way to get a hold of Terrence.
So should I just go up and talk to them?
Just ask them.
Okay, okay.
We checked with the cops.
No cops.
I mean, we checked the hospital. We checked the hospital.
No hospital records. No known family members that he could have disappeared to.
Just go up
to
them.
Okay. Hey, I'm a friend of T-Rex. T-Rex, he's a regular in this room. What the fuck?
Oh,
great. Never mind.
We call, we knock. Nothing.
So, what do you do? Are you just throwing all his stuff in the garbage, or...? Do you see this?
Exactly, am I looking for here?
Come on, open up. Ah, two more minutes. Just two more minutes, okay? I don't know what more we can do in reality to find this man.
We should take into consideration that the mothership came back.
You know that's funny. It's okay to laugh.
What are you gonna do, man? Are you gonna give up, or...?
I honestly don't know.
Hear what I just said, buddy? Don't question what I'm seeing with my own eyes, all right?
And there's that fucking guy. Get that guy. Get the guy right on the corner there. This guy's been shadowing. He's a spook.
I think the guy's there for a ride, man.
I'm seeing him everywhere. Hey, fuck you!
Fuck you!
People don't just disappear.
Don't get this on camera. Don't get this conversation on camera.
Look, say hi. Say hi to Daddy Zuby.
Hi. Get the fuck out of here, baby.
Head of security of Pakistan
wires $100,000 to Muhammad Atta just prior to the 911 attacks. Then on the morning of the attacks, Ahmed is in Washington having breakfast.
Shut the fuck up.
Yes. I'm surprised you're aware of the report at the time that ISI chief was in Washington on September 11th and on September 10th, $100,000 was wired from Pakistan to these groups here in this area.
I have not seen that report, and he was certainly not meeting with me.
Why
yes.
is the guy who bankrolled 9/11 meeting with the CIA on the morning of the attacks?
United Flight 93. Show me the picture of any plane crash. 3,000 people were murdered that day, right? 3,000 people.
How many people?
Right. Nobody could fucking plan something like this.
How many people died in World War One?
What are you fucking going on about now?
World War One. 1913. It's a fact that Woodrow Wilson's senior advisor, Edward House, deliberately sent a passenger ship, the RMS Lusitania, into German-controlled waters with the intention that it be hit by a U-boat, which it was. And that brings America into World War One. Gulf of Tonkin! Gulf of Tonkin! Two U.S. boats are attacked by three Vietnamese boats. And that's what brings the U.S. into the Vietnam conflict. 2005, the NSA releases a classified document that states the Gulf of Tonkin incident never happened. Never happened.
If you look at 9/11 in isolation, it's unbelievable to think that we could be told such a huge lie. But if you look at the broad picture of history, you can see that staging attacks against one's own country is one of the oldest and most commonly used tactics for starting war.
What is?
Just if Terrence and guys like him, you know, if they're wrong, then it's really fucked up that they could be so delusional. But if they're not,
you want to do it. You want to do it. You know you want to do it.
I mean, like for me, right? Like, I mean, I'm looking at like right now. I'm it's as desperate as like matching like the hues of highlight, and also looking where the pins are. Like my project today that we're gonna try to record is like putting the pins exactly where the holes are, and just seeing because he's got like the string of dates here, and he's clearly connected them to like important events
of some sort.
You know, so I mean, that's what he was investigating.
I know, but Aaron.
What?
I just don't see the point, dude, of you trying to pursue an unbalanced man's, you know.
When did you decide that for sure? That he's unbalanced.
What is it? What is it you're looking at? What is it you're piecing together?
I don't know yet. I don't know what it is. We don't know what it is. Every other time that Terrence put one of his blue thumbtacks into the chart, it's because he was connecting some event to a greater pattern.
Whether you agreed with the pattern he saw,
it doesn't matter. The point is he always had one.
He has every major conspiracy theory on there. If you stare at it long enough, you're going to see whatever you want to see.
Have a nice holiday. Yep. Have a nice holiday.
All right.
I need a break.
You see, the thing about the belief in conspiracy theories is that you can't disprove them. You can't prove that there aren't secret masters trying to control and manipulate us. Paranoid schizophrenics will often subconsciously create delusions that can't be disproved. This allows them to have the delusion go on indefinitely. Now, I'm not saying that all people that believe in conspiracy theories are schizophrenics. However, if the delusion goes unchecked, the result can lead sometimes to very dangerous consequences, as it did in this case.
Up.
Didn't know we were filming this.
He said he guaranteed it'll be worth it.
Okay. At first, I was too focused on the events. You know, the formation of the Fed, World War I, 9/11. Then I decided to refocus on these string of dates, right? All of which take place before major world events. So I decided to put it into Google.
Dude. If you put those dates into Google, it's going to spit out all kinds of crazy
things. I find this article. It's written in 2003, published in Time magazine. It's all about this thing called the Tarsus Club, which is like a retreat for politicians, for corporate leaders, people like major world players. A guy named Murray Chance. He's a founder of Chance Investments, and they also had offices in World Trade Center Building 7.
Okay. So,
the article refers to specific Tarsus meetings in April 1946, May 1962, May 2001. So, April 46, May 62, May 2001. This got the ball rolling. All of Terrence's dates refer to specific meetings of the Tarsus Club, all of which take place right before major world events. That's what the dates are. That's what Terrence is looking into.
It was loose. Assumptions built upon other assumptions, but, you know, I'll give it to him. He found a pattern. He connected the dots. Terrence would have been proud of him.
Tarsus Club is a membership-only annual retreat for global innovators with an emphasis on strengthening global networking, leadership skills, and relationship building.
What does that mean?
I have no fucking clue. There's absolutely no actual information on this site.
Well, they have a phone number. That's your number.
Yeah.
6-4-7-2-8-5-1-9-8-9. Did everything we could think of to track down this guy, Mark Tucker, who
who'd written the article. I contacted Time. They said that he had left the magazine years ago. Literary agencies, publishing houses. The article seemed to be the sole evidence of this guy ever existing.
You think that Mark Tucker is an alias?
So then we had the crazy idea we would take everything that we had found out about the Tarsus Club, put it online, and see what came out of the woodwork. What is this?
Fuck off.
What are you on?
Nothing. This is my, little escape.
Oh, this is the farmer website thing you're always on.
It's called an off-grid community. It's being built in northern Alberta. Oh, fuck! You assholes! Fuck off, man! Come on! It's, like, completely self-sufficient. We're gonna grow our own food, like, dig our own wells. It's a group of 50 of us. Planning on building this thing, so you know, it's like sometimes I just feel like just start over, get away from this whole fucked up world.
Last night, Aaron got an email from someone saying that he wanted to meet on the conspiracy chat room site. Said we can talk about Murray Chance and the Tarsus Club. The thing is that Aaron, in what he posted online, never mentioned Murray Chance. So, we'll see.
Making a documentary film. Why? Who are you?
How do we know you didn't just Google the article?
Right.
Time?
How do we know that you didn't just Google the Time magazine article?
Doing a bio piece on Murray Chance and his family. And quite by accident, I stumbled on the fact that the Chance family, going back generations, had attended this annual retreat held by an organization called the Tarsus Club. Now, I was told that these meetings were not about setting policy or agenda. But the more I looked into them, the more I realized this couldn't be further from the truth. Very real and tangible shifts in world financial markets, in foreign policy, and even in so-called random events coincided with these retreats.
But in your article, you make it sound like it's just a group of rich white men getting together and having a good time. It doesn't seem really all that nefarious.
That's because when my editor at Time magazine found out what I was reporting on, he butchered the article.
Then why not get rid of the article entirely?
Well, it's in the group's best interest to have a little bit of information out there about themselves. A total media blackout is a void just asking to be filled by fertile imaginations. I wouldn't be surprised that in the very near future that Tarsus purposely lets a little bit of information out there. News story, press release, something that has the appearance of being objective, but has been engineered by them.
So that they can control the message.
And it also acts as a little bit of a warning. You know, they allow you to get a glimpse of how powerful they are.
Warning for who?
People like yourself. People who have discovered the truth.
Did this man ever contact you about the Tarsus Club?
Couldn't honestly say. But your friend may have tried to contact me. But you have to understand that my article is the only mainstream document out there that people can find actual information of Tarsus. But the truth is, most of these guys have monikers and they're far too suspicious ever to meet.
So where is all of this leading? What is it specifically that the Tarsus organization is after?
Three words. New World Order.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
A blueprint of a one world government, a single organization that controls every nation and every person on this planet.
Alice Bailey, H.G. Wells, Adolf Hitler, Gorbachev, George Soros, Herbert Walker Bush, all these people have at some point or another called for a new world order.
A new world order is likely to emerge from the current economic crisis.
About the future of the whole region. It's about the future of Europe and a new world order.
I think a new world order is emerging, and with it the foundations of a new and progressive era of international cooperation.
Mysterious attacks that justify war, trade deals that erase borders, stock market collapses that shift billions in wealth. All these events that gradually shifted more power into fewer hands, the hands of seemingly disconnected individuals who are in fact all linked by one common element, Tarsus.
Didn't you guys get the idea that Mark was like ex-CIA or something? Like,
oh man, totally. Like a retired spook or something, yeah.
Well, I think it's really important. No, listen to me, I'm serious. That we don't get ahead of ourselves with this guy. For everything that this guy spoke about, I can find 10 other guys that can challenge and refute him. For all we know, we're just talking to Terrence in better clothes.
Dude, this is real. This is not some fringe fabrication. You know, he's talking about real facts, right? Hey.
What are you looking at?
Is that the same guy that was in front of Terrence's place? Get that on camera.
I don't know.
It does look like him.
It is, right?
I don't know, man.
I think when Aaron's apartment was burglarized, a line had been crossed. At least a line had been crossed in Aaron's mind. The police didn't find any evidence to suggest that it was anything other than common thieves. They certainly didn't find anything to suggest that it was at all linked to the film that they were making. But I think at that point, it almost didn't matter who it was.
Hey.
Hey, thanks for having me, Craig.
Probably put your stuff in the couch. Just come on
in. Right here, dude.
I just want to go back over a few things that we discussed last time we met. I mean, how do you quantify the decision of...
Why doesn't anyone ever try to do anything about these people? You know, like, expose them, something. What is it that really happens at these things? You wrote, the drinking and deal-making all ends at midnight when the attendees participate in the ritual hunting and slaughter of the bull. What's that about?
The ritual. The ritual is... based on an ancient and highly secret set of beliefs.
Which are what?
The worship of Mithras.
The cult of Mithras was both an association and a religious cult focused on the worship of this god, Mithras.
Mithras was a deity that first appeared in Persia over 4,000 years ago. Now, according to the myth, he was born on the 25th of December. He died and was resurrected 3 days later. Bear in mind, this was 2,000 years before the birth of Christ. Many scholars believe that this is the basis of Christianity. Mithraic caves where they secretly worshipped have been discovered throughout the former Roman Empire, from Scotland to Russia, from the Sahara Desert to the heart of India. This was essentially the world's first truly secret society.
So yes, there probably were quite a few Mithraists who had the ear of quite powerful people. I don't know about modern secret societies with wide agendas. Again, if I did, I wouldn't tell you.
The depiction of Mithras hunting and killing the bull is to the Mithraics what the crucifixion was to the Christians. It is the central image of their belief system. Would you like to see the Mithraic secret handshake? Just do what I do. Follow my movements exactly. Okay.
It's a regular handshake.
The custom that we have of shaking our friends' hands when we meet them on the street or when we seal a business deal comes directly from the secret handshake of the Mithraics. The first ever depiction of people shaking hands in human history comes from a 4,000-year-old carving of Mithras shaking the hands of the Syrian king Antiochus. We live in a world...
we're going to turn the bull loose.
That has been built and guided by cultural forces that exist behind those we see in the forefront.
These are politicians arriving at or leaving a Tarsus meeting in 06. 04, 02.
strong advocate of pushing Canada towards a North American union. He's also a frequent attendee of Tarsus retreats.
Coincidence, I'm sure.
Holy shit. Did you take these?
Yep. I've tried approaching news agencies. No one will touch this stuff.
What's that one?
That's the Bull Hunt. It was taken outside Prague in 2002. It's one of the only known photos of a Tarsus ritual in progress.
Yeah, the camera's off. Has anyone ever tried to infiltrate one of these meetings?
It's possible.
I mean, how would you even go about sneaking into one of these things?
From time to time, sources find out where the Tarsus meeting is going to take place before it happens instead of after. And when that happens, I think it's just a case of, delicacy, money, and I guess just how far you're willing to go.
That's the lens?
And it just clips right on your tie. Just like a tie clip, so that's it.
Look at that. Now, is that recorded the same tiny drive as the other one?
Yeah.
That is badass.
So what are you guys using this for, if you don't mind me asking?
No. Yeah, we're infiltrating a secret society.
Okay, thanks.
I'll slow down, we'll see. Fuck.
What?
He's there.
He's still there. He's still following us. Are you sure?
Okay, make a right up here. Make a right up here. Let's just keep testing this, okay?
Right.
Just keep turning.
You go?
I can't go into traffic, man.
Pull into this parking
Why?
Lot here. Just pull into the parking lot. There's lots of
Why
people.
Am I gonna
pull lots
my...
of people there. It'll be safe. Fingerprint on it. Okay, how's that? Can you see it?
Yeah, I know what it is. I can see it.
Of course, yeah. I'm saying if you didn't know what it was, would you notice it? Look at a camera in one of these fucking things.
What are you guys using those cameras for? What are you using them for, Jim?
Nothing. We're not using them for anything.
I don't give a fuck about the film anymore.
You don't give a fuck about the film?
It has gone too far.
This is not about the fucking film. This is not about the fucking film, okay?
Do you have any idea what would happen to me and my family if I would get caught?
Do you understand?
I understand.
Are you too scared? I need to know if it is that you're too scared. Or do you not believe what's right in front of your eyes?
I really don't think that Jim's mind is capable of accepting that the world doesn't work the way that, he was always told it works.
Okay, all right. For a minute,
Let's say that Aaron is right. Okay? Let's say they're all right. It's all true that there are these people that secretly run things. Then they've always run things. Okay? And they always will.
Is it still there?
Yes, it's still out there.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Still plugged in. Hang on.
Quiet.
You got it?
I'm coming.
All right, fuck. Is it the same one?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Nothing, babe. Go back to bed, okay?
What are you guys doing? Who's out there?
No one's out.
Jim, what are you guys looking at? Yeah, it's right.
Forty-5 minutes. And we're just gonna sit here and watch it all night. I'm sick of this, man. I'm sick of being afraid. Fuck it.
Fuck it. You know Aaron. This is what they want. This Aaron. Is what they want us to fucking.
Aaron, just sit
Aaron,
down.
Keep your voice
sit
down.
Aaron, just wait a second. Aaron, what are you doing?
Sure you don't want to come?
close.
We got separated for any reason. Let's meet back here.
Is that it?
Yeah. That's it. Okay. Let's get comfortable. You don't have to come. Really.
You could just leave.
The very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society. And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings. For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence, on infiltration instead of invasion, on subversion instead of elections, on intimidation instead of free choice, on guerrillas by night instead of armies by day. It is a system which has conscripted vast human and material resources into the building of a tightly knit, highly efficient machine. Its preparations are concealed, not published. Its mistakes are buried, not headlined. Its dissenters are silenced, not praised. No expenditure is questioned. No rumor is printed. No secret is revealed.
I got you. Just hang on.
Hey,
John.
Evening.
Evening.
Two gin and tonics, please.
Thank you.
Yes.
Oh, what are the young bucks drinking then, huh? What do you got there, ginger ale? You're not that young, are you?
It's G&T.
Gin and tonic.
Gin and tonic. I'm a gin and tonic. I like spinning with this younger crowd here. Nice to meet you, brothers.
Nice to meet you, brother.
You too, brother.
First time?
Yes.
Yes. That's right. Yep.
That's Ravens.
Yes, exactly.
Absolutely.
I'm a lion myself. As you can tell by my hairline. So those are problems they can't solve, huh?
What are you gonna do, eh?
Still some problems you can't solve.
Do I detect a hint of the Great White North in that accent?
You're good.
You boys are.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, that's right.
Good stuff. Well, brothers, enjoy the hunt.
Yes. Nice meeting you, brother.
Yes.
Nice meeting
you.
It's good to meet you, brother. Good evening, brother.
Good evening, brother.
Enjoying yourself so far?
Absolutely.
Yes, definitely.
Enjoyment is the first clue, not the destination. The pieces are fantastic, aren't they?
Spectacular.
Great to have met you, brother.
You too.
Yes, thank you.
Enjoy the rest of the night, brothers. community of stars, forming one constellation, a circle of brothers, forming one family.
No, no, it's okay, brothers. I just need to speak with my friend for a second.
Get back. Wait, Lauren,
it's very important that I talk with him.
My name is Jim. My father's name is David.
Please get out of my way.
You caused a disturbance. Remember your place.
No disturbance meant.
Amplius Oro.
Second.
line and stay there.
I'm very sorry, brothers. My apologies. Enjoy the evening.
Thank you.
Your life has just turned on the great pivot.
Yes. Thank you.
Kneel, Appius Oro. How did you find the initiation experience?
Unique. I've never experienced anything quite like it.
It can all be a little overwhelming.
Yes. It was a little yes.
You've joined a circle that can never be broken. Brotherhood. A family. No less than, say, a wife or a small child.
My name is Aaron. My father's name was John.
I'd like to show you something.
No, no, I will.
If you have a moment. It'll only take a second.
Give me 1 second. I have to use the bathroom. Right back. Tracy.
The fuck?
No. Wait. Okay, wait. I'm sorry. I'm not a part of this. No, okay. I'm sorry. Wait. I'll just go. Jim.
Aaron.
No.
The core value of the Tarsus Club is communications. Communications between governments, businesses, individuals. And of course, we're living in the golden age of communications because of globalization. Unfortunately, with the rise of the internet, there's a dark side to globalization. Essentially, that is that anyone with a crazy idea can communicate it to millions of people, like a virus. And the Tarsus Club has been the target of these viruses, including these crazy conspiracy theories.
Well, actually, it's become something of a cottage industry, I think, within conspiracy circles to break in to Tarsus meetings. In fact, we've grown so accustomed to it over the years that it's almost become part of the ritual to scare people off who try to break in.
I was taken to a back room.
I was told to let them know where the rendezvous point was with Aaron. We were questioned for a very long time, but eventually security let us go. Even after Aaron realized that they were just scaring him, he was still very upset. I think Aaron had been traumatized by what had happened. That was the last time I saw him.
So the people screaming about conspiracy, I'll let them in on a little secret. It's true. Global leaders do get together and collaborate. Many of them, including my boss, Murray Chance, are working hard to create a new world where all nations and all people can come together in one global community. That's what it's all about. The creation of a single global community. And if that's a conspiracy, well then yes, we're guilty.
Just for the record, where do you think Aaron went?
I guess he ended up in the same place Terrence did, didn't he? And I just hope wherever they are, they both feel free.